Hey, Andre, and this is Dre Trading. Kind of a garbage day today. I feel it's a continuation of the last couple of days where it's just kind of been like day trader type behavior, kind of moving the markets around. Damn those day traders. Why aren't they Dre traders? Yeah. But like the last couple of days, I think people have kind of been getting out of the good stuff and, going into, kind of like the things that haven't been that great in history. It's just like Macy's, the airlines and stuff like that that have been down recently. So they've been getting out of like good normal stuff that I'm in. They've been getting into those. And I think today is just a different type of version of that, where it's just like, the market's been doing well and they're taking profits. And the thing that makes me kind of worried about is what tomorrow brings, because usually Friday is the day that it's just like people take profits for the week. It's just like, let's ride this wave till basically the last minute and then, sell, because that's kind of what happened today, that it was, selling around 3 o'clock. It might be a little bit before that, but around that. And I don't know any like real big news that people didn't really already kind of know about at the beginning of the day to make it sell off. So it kind of makes me just think it's, people that know what they're doing and like kind of know how the game works, selling ahead of time. And it might just be like, Thanksgiving, where everybody says it's like, oh, I'm not going to travel on Thanksgiving. I'm going to go the night before. I'm going to be smart. I'm going to miss all that traffic. And everyone travels the night before, so you end up hitting it all anyway. So, today may have been that. It's like all the smart traders are trading today, was selling today. So, and that's why it went down, but so we'll see what tomorrow brings. Is it gonna just be a long sell off and, tomorrow's gonna be, just a continuation of the end of today, or is it gonna go back up and stuff like that? And I don't know. It's like I said, I think a lot of this is kind of been bouncing around what, people that trade a lot are doing, and that's why, the basic normal stocks have kind of been stagnant, and like kind of other loser type names like Macy's and stuff like that. I'm really picking on Macy's. I'm sorry, Macy's. Probably because I had them at one point and they lost me money. But overall, kind of a garbage day, and I think my stuff kind of stank, but I think at least one of my pot stocks did well. But overall, kind of a loser day, just kind of a blah. Hopefully tomorrow is gonna bring it better, but then again, it's just like you have to expect bad days. How many good days have we had since, I just even started this channel at one? And even that, it was just like, what, it may have been a bad day for me, but good for everybody else, who knows? But so for today, we have my best one, Canopy Growth. That's, so many times that comes out being good. I mean, I know a couple of times it's been a double digit loser, but Canopy Growth up 9.15. I'm happy to see that. AstraZeneca finally making money, but I'm still in the red for it ultimately. And I think I saw it up after hours, so I'm hoping they found the cure for all human ills and all of a sudden I'll be a billionaire. But that was up a measly 1.96. Aurora Cannabis up 0.26. And then I get into mutual funds. So everything after this is red. So everything after this I should have put into the mutual funds if I wanted to make money on the day. But here we go with Take Two, the least of the losers. It was down 0.33. Tesla down 1.76. Beyond Meat 1.89. Tilray down 2.44. Green Organic down 4.37. And Twitter down 4.45. And I say Twitter like that because I have no idea what to do with Twitter. I have no idea what to do with social media stuff. I think it's just going to be a hotbed for political, craziness and people double downing on each side. And I don't care what political thing people fall on. I just don't want it in my stocks. It's just like people can fight, just, stay out of my money with it. But I don't want to cut off my nose to spite my face. I kind of did that with Facebook in the past. It's like I had Facebook And around the 2016 aftermath, it's just like when they were being dragged into Congress and this, that, and the other thing. It's just like I didn't want anything to do with it, so I got out of there. I don't think they pay a dividend, so it's kind of like I can put my money into Apple or something like that. Something that is farther away from, deciding what's true and isn't true, fact-checking type stuff. And then I kind of like got into Twitter, and I kind of still want to be into Twitter because, like, kind of unlike Facebook, even though Facebook is more profitable, and I probably would have been better off financially to be in Facebook compared to Twitter. I don't think they've been better than Apple, but Twitter, it's just like, being angry at oxygen. Like, if all of a sudden people hated water, it's like all of a sudden, like, oh yeah, no one's gonna want water again. It's just like people kind of need it. It's like, what you go on, what else can take the thing of Twitter? Now, they don't make money because of, like, they don't make a lot of money because of, like, they don't know how to make good money off of ads and stuff like that. But it's just like, even people that hate it, I mean, it seems like Twitter is just like, who likes Twitter? It's just like whenever you hear about Twitter, people are just complaining about it. Everyone hates Twitter, but everyone stays on it because that's how you communicate. Like, I mean, I'd be more than happy to buy the next Twitter, but the next Twitter doesn't seem like it's coming yet. Believe me, it's like the second like a new Twitter comes, I'm selling this Twitter that I got, and it's just like I'm gonna buy that. And I know 10 years down the line, people are gonna hate that too, and they're gonna, like, the people on this side are gonna say it's this, and people on that side are gonna say it's that, and that's gonna go down the same tubes. But right now, it's like that's the only tube in town. It's just like where you go for, like, quick information and stuff like that. That's, kind of worth investing in. I have no idea. So I think I'm gonna stay with Twitter. I don't know. I kind of want to sell it just because I don't want to, like, think about the headlines about it. That it's just like once I sold the Facebook stock that I had, like, back in the day, it's just like, yeah, whenever I, and same thing happened with Tesla. It's just like when I sold it, it's like, yeah, don't care when this is in the headlines. Doesn't have anything to do with me. So I might sell it just for that. But it's kind of like, I want to be in it because everyone else is in it. Even people that hate it are in it. But it's not really good to be in a stock that basically all its consumers despise. It's just like, the second people can jump ship, they're gonna. And it's such a annoying thing to be in, and I have no idea what's gonna happen. So, but I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna see where it goes. And who knows, maybe a year from now it's gonna be, the only game in town because people are leaving Facebook, and they're gonna find better ways to, put revenue on the thing. But or it could be MySpace. But I tell you, if a year from now there's a new spot, MySpace, I'm definitely gonna have sold my Twitter. And even if it was like a day where it was down 10%, if there's a new Twitter, I'm selling whatever I got, whatever losses I have, and I'm jumping into the new Twitter, because I really don't like to be in things that are in the news. So overall, I think I was red on the day. Kind of a garbage day altogether. I think the strategy is still going to be the same. I think it's going to be a long time till there's going to be good NASDAQ days. I think, the bad Dow days are going to be kind of around the corner. All of a sudden, it's just like, but like I said before, maybe people are going to be getting into those stocks that were kind of down before that make the Dow go up. Or, it's going to be a lot like today, where it's just like there's going to be a couple of days where it's big Dow off of kind of like loser one time, spike type things, and then everybody selling their money again, and then today happening again. But I have no idea. All I know is, some people are making a lot of money, some people are losing a lot of money, and I'm kind of just sitting here being frustrated about it. But, we'll see what happens when the market's open tomorrow, and it'll just be another day, right?